we're going to leave it there, and we're going to talk to a parent whose children were involved in this exhibit. We appreciate your time. We're going to continue this discussion as well. A well-known child psychiatrist, Dr. Alvin Poussin, who's going to also be joining the conversation. Back to our conversation about a provocative photo essay called In the Playroom. It shows photographs of children with toys reenacting tragic and violent events like September 11th, Hurricane Katrina, and Abu Ghraib prisoner abuse scandal torture. Amanda Etheringe is the mother of two children who appear in one of the photos in the exhibit, and she joins us from Ottawa. Also joining us from Boston is child psychiatrist Dr. Alvin Poussin. Dr. Poussin, thank you, both of you, for being with us here. I want to start with you. What was your first impression when you saw this photo exhibit?
My first impressions?
Yes.
My first impressions was it looked pretty scary at first. On the other hand, I realize that a lot of children are exposed to a lot of violence. They've seen many of these images on the front page of the newspaper, on the 6 o'clock news. So it's not like this is a first time for them. Is it appropriate?
Yes.
Well, it depends. I think some of it is appropriate. I don't know that it's appropriate to put a scarf around a young girl's neck like she's going to be strangled without her really understanding what that's about, or in fact it being scary for her. I think you can't use the children in a way that's going to traumatize them or frighten them. So I think what was going on most of the time, a lot of the children thought this was like make-believe, like it was Halloween or they were in a haunted house, but they really didn't understand the purpose surrounding what they were doing. And I think it's very important that the photographer talk to the children beforehand, the parents talk to them beforehand, understand what they know, make sure this is not going to be a negative experience. And I think afterward, you know, they have to do follow-up and see how the children reacted to that experience, because maybe in 3 months or 6 months, it may mean something different to them. Maybe that it was very upsetting to participate in such a project. But on the other hand, they have an opportunity to act it out a little bit, something like play, but it's not quite like that. But I commend the photographs in the sense that I think it does raise the consciousness of everyone, including adults and including parents, that children are being affected by the events around them, by war, by disasters, by earthquakes.
I want to bring in Ms. Etherington, if I can. Your daughter and son posed in one of the photos. Your daughter was 5 at the time, your son 3, I believe. This is a reenactment of the disappearance of the Alabama high school student, Natalie Holloway, who went on a trip to Aruba, a spring break trip, met up with Jurrit Vandersloot, who was suspected in her disappearance. Her body has never been found. Your daughter in this picture is posing as Holloway, one of your sons, as one of the, I'm assuming, the frat boys that she partied with. Can you first of all just tell us why it was that you decided to have your children participate in taking this photo?
I think at the time when Jonathan spoke to us about doing the photo, we thought it was an interesting concept. And also, I do believe that nowadays, with media and what children are exposed to, you really can't sort of hide from it what your children are going to see. At the same time, we were very hands-on with Jonathan during the shoot. We were present at all times. And, you know, he kept us abreast of the situation about what he was going to do. And the images that you see are sort of a picture taken of a development of play. It's not like it's initially starts out as that picture. I mean, they're sort of playing. My children saw it as very much like when we go to the beach and we bury each other in the sand.
Did you explain to your daughter or your son what they were reenacting or what this was supposed to represent? What did you tell your children?
At the time, of course, my children were 5 and 3, which is far too young to have that sort of discussion. As my children have gotten older, we have discussed the pictures that they have been in. We've talked very openly about how do they feel about it, what their memories are of the picture. I think it's very important to have open dialogue with your children to discuss what it is they see, because I think when you're young, the world can be a scary place if you don't have somebody to talk to about what it is you're seeing. It can be very confusing, the images that are on television, in the newspaper. So for us as a family, it has brought a lot of these conversations out into the open about what goes on in the world.
Do you worry at all that there's going to be backlash for your children being in such a public way and posing in these pictures in an exhibit? Does that concern you at all?
Absolutely, absolutely. And I think the biggest thing at the end of the day is it's we as adults who are the ones who it's merely the way that we see the photograph. And I think it comes down to us as adults. If you take, for example, the picture that my children are in, if you take the title off of the picture or the context of what the picture is about, it's merely just children playing in the sand.
Dr. Poisson, if I could, children often use play to understand the world around them. How should parents explain things that are very difficult to deal with and understand, like 9/11 or Abu Ghraib? Is this potentially a teaching moment for these parents or these kids?
Yeah, it's potentially a teaching moment when other children see these images in a particular, and even adults. But first you have to find out what they know. I think she's right, a three-year-old child is not going to really know what's going on. But an eight-year-old may really understand that these images are part reality because they've seen things on the news and they've seen things in the newspaper. So I think you have to talk to children about the world around them and the awful things that frequently happen to help prepare them to be adults in American society. But I think we can't, in this case, use children and exploit them and not tell them what's going on, that you have to at least ask them, what do you think this is all about? And also allow them not to participate, not to put any pressure on them that they have to do this or seduce them into doing it when they really don't understand what's happening.
Dr. Poussant, Ms. Etherington, I appreciate your time and for both of you coming on to discuss this very controversial exhibit. Thanks. We'll be right back after this break.